Welcome to the Snapshot, a new Platts series that examines the forces that are shaping and driving the global commodities markets. In this episode, we are focusing on what's happening with the profitability of coal-to-olefins and methanol-to-olefins in China amid plunging global crude oil prices. China has been embarking on a massive investment aiming at producing petrochemicals from coal and methanol, something no other country has been trying to do on such a massive scale. Olefins capacity in China from CTO and MTO has been exploding and will continue to balloon this year and next year as well. The narrative so far has been that high crude oil prices had given MTO and CTO a competitive edge compared with naphtha-based production, which is typically closely tracking crude oil prices. When crude is relatively high, we can see that using coal or methanol to produce petrochemicals is very competitive compared to naphtha-based production. We can see this, for instance, in the profits of high-density polyethylene and polypropylene when we compare these three feedstocks. Indeed, when crude was at three-digit levels, profit margins for naphtha-based producers had been way below CTO and MTO. They were so small for naphtha-based that they were barely visible as of June 2014. But times have changed. Since June 2014, crude oil prices have sunk to levels not seen in 12 years, and naphtha has been largely tracking that. How has that been hitting the profitability of CTO and MTO? Naphtha has regained its lost territory for the moment, while production margins for CTO and MTO have been under pressure. If more CTO and MTO comes online, it may pressure downstream prices, pressuring margins further. At this point, it is far too early to say that the curtain for coal to olefins and methanol to olefins is going to close already, after having just been raised. But the timing of these massive startups in the near future does not come at a great moment in global commodities markets. Until next time on The Snapshot, we shall keep an eye on the markets.